Welcome back to my channel. This is our second video for writing the code for this ATmega328. This microcontroller is used in this security system. It is for mains failure detector, and it also controls the battery from overcharging. In our last video, we wrote the code for battery charging protection, and today we will see this circuit, how it is working. Line and neutral are provided to bridge rectifier. After that, these voltage are provided to this capacitor, and then we have a voltage dropper resistors, 100k and 2.2k resistor, to limit the current. These are connected in series with this LED to the LED of optocoupler. When the mains is present at that time, this optocoupler will activate and it will cause to couple the ground level to pin number 4 of this optocoupler, and it will reach to pin number 17, that is PB3. PB3, that is programmable pin, that is the pin name, pin function name. It is pin number 17 of the IC, but physically its name, its address, that is PB3, PB0, 1, 2, 3. So it is sense line. We can say it is input. And then if the optocoupler is off, there is no light present here at input, what will happen? Its transistor will open. At that time, the positive voltage will cause to pull up through this pull up resistor, and pin number 17 will go high. So we can say we have a pull up resistor. Now we have condition, if the electric is available, means present, pin number 17 will low. If it is present, it will low. If it is not present, it will high. At that time, in this condition, if the pin number 17 is high, it will cause to operate the relay. Our microcontroller will do this function, and the relay is connected to pin number 16, that is K1 relay. So pin number 16, that is PB2 relay, is connected to PB2, that is pin number 16 of the IC. Today we are not using any external programmers, universal programmer. We are programming this IC in this Arduino Uno board. So let's cross check the pins. Here it is using the same ATmega328 IC, and if we see PB2, that is here pin number 16, it is connected to pin number 3. We can say in Arduino pin number 3, this is output pin. When we will write the code, we will define this pin as output pin. And if we check the PB3, that is pin number 17, exactly that is here, it is pin number 11. In the Arduino board, it will pin number 11. The physical pin of the IC is 17, but Arduino we will take here. So 11 number pin, that is input. It is a best practice to rename the pins. If we say pin number 11 of Arduino, we can say this pin is used as an input, and it is used to electric detect. When we will write the code, we will rename this pin as this word, so we can understand the code very easily how it is working. Okay, when it will decide what it will do, we can say a relay drive. This is the output pin, that is pin number 3. Let's write the code and then we will check it practically. open the Arduino IDE. Now we have two pins. It is very simple code. We will write the function electric detect, electdect, equal to which pin? That is pin number 11, colon integer relay drive, that is pin number 3, that is as the output pin, colon. Write the comment here, this pin is to detect the presence of mains voltage. We defined the pin name. Anyone who will see this code in future, he can understand what is the function of this pin. Now write the second comment, when the mains is off, Arduino will drive this pin high. Define the role of pins. Pin mode, this electric detect pin mode the same, comma, input, colon. Always use terminator. The second pin, pin mode relay drive, that is pin number 3. Always use the same declared names. It is output pin, terminator. Now we will write main program body, that is loop function. The program will run again and again. This code will run just only once in the startup, but this body, this bracket, it will run again and again. Now what we need to do, when the program will run, it will read the input pin. Now we want to read the pin, that is electric detect. So electric detect, we will define here integer electric value equal to 0. What is this? This electric value, we say it is initially the light is off. This condition, the system will compare this electric value with its new reading. Electric value, that is equal to, what is the electric value? Digital read from where? From this electric detect pin, colon. Now we defined anything it will read from this pin number 11, that is electric detect, it will called as a electric value. We will write now if and else function. If else, in the if section we will give some condition. We will say something that if this is true, if electric value, now if electric value not equal to 0, this is our condition. Now what will happen? Now the decision will start from here. This is our condition. If electric value, where is electric value? This one, which we read, digitally read from electric detect pin, that is pin number 11. If it is not equal to 0, that means the pin is high, which we defined here. What it will do? Digital write, which pin? Relay drive, control C. If electric value is not equal to 0, what is the meaning of this sentence? We said when the mains is present, LED will on, this transistor will active and it will couple to ground. That means when the electric is available, the pin will low. Now we are going to detect the off position. When the light is missing, that means this pin will high. So we said in the statement, if electric value is not equal to 0, that means high, what it will do? Relay drive, comma, high in capital, terminator. So this is our function. Relay will high, else copy the same statement. If the light is present, type here low. This is our program and it is now complete. Compile it. We can say mains failure detector. It is compiling the code. The sketch is compiled. Now we can upload in the Arduino. We will configure it. First we will use a resistor here. I am not using optocoupler. I will use just only the 10 kilo ohm resistor to pull it up. We will give positive voltage, positive 5 volt, that is here. We will connect in one side, okay, and the other side I will connect to pin number 11, that is the input pin. I will connect the ground pin to the ground side. And I will connect pin number 3, that is the output pin. 1, 2 and 3 number pin, that is output pin. And I will give jumper to the LED. LED low side. And I will bring this ground here to pin number 11. So I connected the ground to pin number 11. This time the light is present. I will connect in. I connected to the COM port. Now upload the program. Sketch upload. Yes, the software is uploaded. Now the LED is off. If I will open this, when it is high, we can say when we remove the ground, this time the LED is on. So that means our code is working properly. When it is low, when the electric is present, it is low. Pin number 11 is low. At that time this LED will remain off. As the light will off, the mains fail, the LED will turn on. So we can connect the relay module with the same drive. It will work. I hope so you enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed it, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.